In this short video on the difference between nominal and real values, I'll explain why it's important to examine economic data by accounting for inflation. To illustrate the difference between money, or nominal values, and the real value of data, I'll use a table of figures. The first column lists the year, with 1995 set as our base year. The second column lists the money wages earned by a hypothetical worker. For the sake of simplicity, we'll hold a worker's money wages constant. In the third column is a price index, which will indicate the general level of prices in the economy relative to the base year of 1995. As you can see, the price level has increased 100% from 1995 to 2000, 200% from 1995 to 2005, and 300% from 1995 to 2010. Our final column contains the real value of the worker's wages. In the base year, the real value and the nominal value is the same at $100. We'll compare all of our figures against the base year from here. If in 2000 the prices have doubled, then the real value of the worker's wages drops to $50. What he used to be able to buy with $50, he now needs $100 to do so. If his wages are still $100, he can now buy half as much as before. We follow this trend to 2005 and 2010. In 2005, the price level has tripled from 1995, so the worker's wage of $100 now only buys $33.33 worth of goods relative to 1995 prices. Finally, 2010 prices have quadrupled from 1995, so the real value of $100 wages in 2010 is equal to $25 relative to 1995 prices. The GDP deflator is similar to the CPI in that it is a price index, but it is not based on a fixed market basket of goods. It includes new goods and services as well, which could arguably make it a better indicator of changes in the price level. To solve for the GDP deflator, you divide nominal GDP by real GDP and multiply by 100. You can adjust this formula to solve for real GDP and nominal GDP. It is unlikely that you will have to solve this kind of problem for CIE economics, but it is good to know the formula and understand the limitations of the CPI as a measure of inflation. That wraps up our short video on nominal and real values. I hope it's clear now that you've seen it with some numerical values over time. It is a relatively straightforward concept that is key in your understanding of economics. If you found this video helpful, go ahead and subscribe or hit the like button. Leave me a comment below to let me know if you have any questions. You can always email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com or tweet me at EnhanceTuition. Until then, I will see you in the next one.